head-to-head, incidentally, in that first match. Head-to-head record in this one is 2-1 in favour of Sindhu. They first met in Macau last year. As we look at the bracket, the semi-final lineup, Kirsty Gilmore will be going against Ti Ying Ji of Malaysia later. Sindhu won in Macau last year, 21-15, 21-12. Then they met at the Swiss Open back in March. That was much closer. Sindhu won 19-21, 21-16 and 21-11. And then, of course, in the team competition, it was Lee who won 15-21, 22-20. There were no match points, incidentally, and 21-17. So, again, we could be in for a very tight match.
Well, the head-to-head record of the last year and a half may go out the window, but I think the relevance of the team event match that these two ladies played.
You'll see that Sindhu has not dropped a game on her way through. Indeed, she's not lost more than 14 points in a game in the individual competition. Michelle Lee also no games lost. She was taken to 21-18, 21-18 by England's Sarah Walker in the quarterfinals. Michelle Lee is ranked 19 as we look again at Dharampar, against PV Sindhu at 11. And of course, sadly, the gold medalist from 4 years ago in Delhi, Saina Nehwal, not here, from India.
Ready to play?
Just carrying a little injury in which she wanted to protect, with the World Championships coming up at the end of the month in Denmark.
Yes, the golden girl from Delhi 4 years ago, whose gold medal took India to the top of the medal standings. Not able to defend her title, but her young compatriot here, Sindhu, is the favourite. But having lost in the team event to Michelle Lee, really see this game as even at the start. Both players very attacking, Sindhu especially, tall figure, likes to bring the shuttle down with great angles. Always pushing in the midcourt.
Yeah, Sindhu is 5'10", which is tall for a female singles player.
Here we go, Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, PV Sindhu, India. And on my left, Michelle Lee, Canada. Michelle Lee to serve. Love all. Play.
First point goes to Michelle Lee. David, I didn't watch the team event match between these two ladies, but I think that the confidence that Michelle Lee will take from that really will, I think, notice at the start of this game. We'll see how comfortable she is on the stage in the semi-final here.
Just long. No, unfortunately, that Canada-India match is not on a televised court, so I didn't see it either. I mean, Michelle Lee played so well against Liang Zhaozhu in the quarterfinals, the Singaporean, but then not so well against Sarah Walker.
Service over, 2-1.
Fire! Fire!
semi-final of Ti Jingyi and Kirsty Gilmore. I think these ladies maybe know the winner of this one will go into the final as a strong favourite for the gold medal. Sometimes have that, the draws open up and you get one side which is looks stronger and one slightly weaker, and this certainly looks like the stronger half of the draw and the one which may likely produce the gold medal winner.
Say loves to attack Sindhu.
So well, constantly attacking two, in that rally. The final shot down the forehand side of Michelle Lee, who was already on the floor earlier in the rally, recovered well, but the dive this time unable to retrieve the smash. Michelle Lee,
4-2,
with the pressured attack from the rear of the court, stepping forward, only two or three steps and she's in front of the service line, killing it at the feet of the Indian girl.
So the silver, 3-4.
Well, it's good to see the attacking play from the start here by both women, both looking to be a positive, get themselves on the attack. And that one just drifts wide.
So the silver.
Pushing
five,
the forehand
three.
Lift down the line. And it may be a case that we know both ladies have got fantastic attacks. So it could be a case of whoever's got the best defence, recovery, might be the one who progresses in this match.
Wide, and that was good defence from Michelle Lee in the middle of that rally.
Well, the round the head technique movement by both players really is outstanding. Michelle Lee really supple moving around the head. High serve has landed plumb on the line. Misjudgment by Sindhu.
Remember, in singles, it is the back line that counts for serving, and for everything else for that matter.
Sindhu going for a little bit too much on the angle, and it's as we may have expected, Michelle Lee taking that confidence of the victory earlier last week in the team events against India, and opening up a healthy 5-point lead in the first game of this semi-final.
Silver, 4-8.
and the Indian team always strong, really are, seem to be stronger in the singles events always, never really producing any really world-class doubles, certainly men's doubles and mixed doubles pairs recently. And they have got a strong representative in both men's and singles here in the semi-finals.
Yeah, there are more Indians in the top 100 of the men's singles world rankings than any other nation, including China, which is quite remarkable.
Well, that is an incredible statistic. Obviously, producing players. We know the Indian Premier League badminton, a huge investment by Indian badminton to try and raise the profile in their own country.
So we're narrowing the gap a little here.
6-8.
And high hopes for the Indian team in the men's singles as well, with Kashyap Parapalli and Guru Sai.
It's gone long.
7-8.
And a 5-point lead that Michelle Lee had at 8-3 is down to one. Yeah, incidentally, Parapalli Kashyap level at one game all against Rajiv Yusuf in the men's singles semi-final on an adjoining court. Yusuf having won the first game. Eight all then.
Drop shot just drifts wide.
Silver, 9-8.
You can see a clear change in Sindhu's tactics here. Before, she was really pushing the attack, going a little bit hard. Now she's taking the pace out a little bit more, trying to limit the errors and make Michelle Lee actually work to win the points and hit winners.
So silver, 9-0.
And the change has certainly been successful so far. And for the first time,
10-9.
Sindhu has the lead.
And it's the mistakes now coming from Michelle Lee's racket, trying to force the attack. This time, the slow pace drop shot to the middle. In ladies singles, we see the four corners used all the time, but the shots to the middle are sometimes just as effective, really give your opponent, actually they have to create the angle from the center of the court rather than playing from the four corners, which is what these guys practice kind of 80-90% of the time.
Yeah, overdoing the angle again.
So the silver, 11-10 interval.
So it is PV Sindhu who has that 1-point advantage as we go into the interval.
One is that little hole, and that little hole, and that initial shot, right? So that first shot that you make her move, yeah? You're in control of this thing, not her. Got it? Oh, she's looking to attack, so she's going to serve you short. She's going to hit down as quickly as she can. So you've just got to control your underhand, okay? With a little bit of deception, as Ryan says. With a little bit of a hold, she has some troubles.
And think about this. She's really tall. She doesn't like height. Most people can't even make
it. 14-27. 14-27.
Well, the Canadian coaches trying to instill the confidence in Michelle Lee, really giving her the belief that she's in control of the game. The way the game's going, it's up to her to dictate the play, saying that Sindhu wants to attack all the time.
11-10.
And that she should be ready for the steep attack.
Jeff White and Ram Nayar, the Canadian coaches.
Come on! 12-10.
The Indian coach matches, incidentally, for Lela Gofichand and Marumuta Bisht.
And interestingly enough, so Lela Gofichand having to watch both games in the arena at the same time. You have a men's singles and a ladies' singles going on the two courts. And he's actually drifting between both courts, advising both his players. Tactically, such a difficult job that is. It's very difficult to cast your eye over two games when the intensity is so high and there's so much at stake. Push we were talking about before the game started. Sindhu likes to attack, step forward. She's got a long stride, really reaches forward, pushing it into the deep corners. This time the miss into the 30. Backhand corner of Michelle Lee brings the scores back level at 13 all.
Come on! Come on! So the silver. 14-13.
That's a fine round the head smash, so Michelle Lee.
14.
Again, these two just can't break away from each other at the moment.
Well, as I said before, the technique round the head by Michelle Lee really is something that any young players looking to improve their movement really have a look at that technique and try and copy it. And the push drifts long at the baseline, encouraged by the Canadian coaches. And this is the last chance for Canada in these Commonwealth Games individual event. Michelle Lee, the last remaining athlete for the Canadians.
So the silver.
Lovely tight net shot. 15. Sindhu.
Yeah, spinning the shuttle. She actually played that one quite high. So it would come down really close to the net. Michelle Lee unable to lift the shuttle back up. And since the gap at the start of this game, it's been very tight. Again,
16-15.
Michelle Lee flicking the forehand. There it is into the corner. And there's the round the head attack again, straight down the line. She'll have practiced that accuracy thousands and thousands of times in practice. And this is where it matters, the big stage.
Thank you.
consistent attack though by Sindhu.
16 all.
Indian lady. Really aggressive attacking one down the forehand side. Pushing it into the backhand and then straight back down the backhand side with the attack.
One of her favourite shots, that
17-16
cut, but getting that one wrong, we saw that a lot in the quarterfinals yesterday. On the line, and it's a good time 18, to be opening 16. Up a two-point lead.
Yeah, she seems to be the more aggressive player on court at the moment, getting the attack the majority of the time now, and it's consistent attack, and that's what's beating Michelle Lee. Sindhu able to get the short shuttle, able to put it away.
Great net shot from so low from Michelle Lee.
17-18.
Well, she was virtually on the floor, and the shuttle taking the net cord. And Sindhu unable to keep the shuttle in the court on the lift, bringing Michelle Lee back to within one as we get to the business end of this first game. And that one went well long of the baseline. And clear by Sindhu. Far too powerful. An easy decision for Michelle Lee to leave it.
Back level once more.
Silver, 19,
Sindhu straight
18.
Back on the attack though. The cross court clear. Far too short by Michelle Lee.
Michelle.
Not having to move much past half court to get back to that attack. She may only be 19 years of age, but she's been around the tour a few years now. I don't expect her lack of experience to be a factor in this match here today.
Oh.
Silver short though. That is a gift at this stage.
19 all.
Well, it certainly is, but it was a clever serve. Serving across Michelle Lee. Michelle Lee actually was slightly wrong-footed, but left the shuttle as it landed short.
Pushed it wide. Sindhu is enraged.
20, game point 19.
Well, she did celebrate when the shuttle hit the floor, but the call was quick by the line judge. The Canadian coaches sitting straight down the line were celebrating immediately, so I do think it did land wide.
And Michelle Lee, if you look, also celebrating immediately. And so, game point for the Canadian.
Fantastic aggression by Sindhu. Played the net shot, really didn't move backwards. Michelle Lee went for the net back. And at 20 all, this match is as tight as we might have expected.
Again, the clear goes long. It's a second game point for Lee.
Well, with a clear by Sindhu, you see it land almost in the centre of the court. She's trying to pull the shuttle cross court. If she could have pulled it cross court, it would have gone in, but it was down the centre. It went long, and it's game point.
And it's Michelle Lee who claims the opening game. What a mistake, it has to be said, from Sindhu, going for too much of an angle.
First game won by Michelle Lee, 22-20.
22-20 to the Canadian after 23 minutes.
Well, Michelle Lee takes it on her second opportunity. Sindhu staying aggressive, still attacking both flanks of the Canadian lady. But in the end, she was just going for a little bit too much with the slice, pulled it wide to give the lower ranked Michelle Lee the first game in this semi-final. Final shot did miss by several inches, going for just too much.
Narumita Bisht.
Well, I think she's going to have to encourage her really strong of mind now. The Indian lady will need to be, having lost in the team event, now lost the first game. The mind does play tricks on you. It'll be really difficult for her to keep this, maintain the strong belief that she can make it through this semi-final. Michelle Lee's confidence will just grow and grow now after that tight first game victory.
And board, please. Second game. Love all.
First game won by Michelle Lee, 22-20. Here we go with the second.
Silver, one, love.
Well, again, a huge stride into the net by Michelle Lee. Really is a great mover around the court.
But just the reaction the
love.
Indian bench would have wanted from Sindhu to losing that opening game.
Landed in as well. And a strong response after dropping the first game. Sindhu coming out the blocks in the second. Strong and focused, just as her coach was telling her to. Giving her the belief. Really instilling that, yes, you can do it attitude in Sindhu.
Sindhu didn't want to change the shuttle, but the umpire says no. It's just been distorted a little, so we'll have a new one. They did want the shuttle changed.
So the silver, 1-3.
Michelle Lee deciding to attack straight down the centre of the court at her opponent. Who was ready, but the power just too much by Michelle Lee. As she gets off the mark in the second game here. Shot there by Sindhu as she stepped forward. Michelle Lee believing she was going to push it flat. And she just pushed it over the head of Michelle Lee. Anticipated the push. There's the clever one over the top. Gave her the smash and they don't come back from the front service line.
4-1 is the score. Sorry, we've just lost the score on the top left of your screen.
5-1.
Trying to restore it. Now 5-1 for Sindhu.
Just look how much that shuttle is spinning as she takes the net shot. Actually hits the net cord twice. Once on the way up, once on the way down. And the cut by Michelle Lee.
2-5.
The opening was there. The Indian coach did advise Sindhu be aware of the cuts of Michelle Lee in the break. That one again is just too good. Always a good tactic against a taller player. Really cut it down low. Sindhu's a player who probably doesn't like really getting low down to the sides. And the healthy lead at 5-1 is being eaten into by the Canadian.
Finds the line.
Silver, silver, 6-3.
Come on again, I think that's her biggest silver weapon, silver. Michelle Lee. Round the head attack. Six. She's having so much success with that side. And she really maintains her balance, even though she's really throwing her body around the head. She's always maintaining the balance so she can hit accurate shots.
4-6 then.
So the silver, 7-4.
It's Michelle Lee with the forehand push this time. Sindhu thought about taking it. Was well advised to leave it. And this time it's the backhand push has landed plumb on the baseline. Michelle Lee's judgment slightly off there. That shuttle was actually well in.
9-4.
And a healthy lead in the second game for Sindhu from India. 5-point advantage, 9-4.
Grueling rally.
5-9.
One of the longest rallies of the match. And a slightly short clear by Sindhu, giving Michelle Lee that opportunity around the head to bring it cross court again.
That's a perfect
6-9.
Perfect serve.
Yes, misjudgment by Sindhu there. The shuttle landing well within. Michelle Lee eaten into this 5-point advantage, brought it back to just 3 at 9-6 here in the second game. Well, that's an incredible shot by
10-6.
Sindhu, just flicking the wrist there. The clear was flat by Michelle Lee, she was on the stretch. Sindhu, that really is a fantastic angle from there. Landing in front of the service line. And she looks to maintain this lead heading into the mid-game interval in the second game.
So the silver, 7-10.
Needs to try and reduce the deficit as we approach the mid-game interval. Now down to 7-10.
And every point at this stage, as you approach an interval, if you're maybe 5 or 6 behind and you can get back to just within 2 or 3 maybe, there's such a different mindset as you go and take the 90-second break.
So the silver, 11-7.
It's a 4-point interval. Lead, 11-7 for the Indian girl. Still maintaining her attacking style of play. She's not going to change from her game plan. She's a very attacking player. Michelle Lee just slightly slow, moving down.
Point 2, 20 seconds. Point 2, 20 seconds.
Great job, Michelle.
Still huge encouragement by the Canadian coaches. Jeff White saying great job, even though his player is trailing 11-7 in the second game. Sometimes it's not all about tactics, it's just about psychology. As a coach now, it's not just about getting your players training, telling 11, them the tactics seven, during the game, eight. Before the game, but also the psychology and adapting to situations as and when they happen during a game, keeping you the head of the player, make sure they're focused all the time.
Silver, 8-11.
Well, it was incredible defense by Sindhu. but she was on the floor and there was no way back. There's no partner in singles to defend for you. Yes. When you're on the floor in singles, the court's wide open and there's very rare a chance to recover. Only the likes of Lee Chongwei and Lin Dan are able to dive, defence, jump back up in the press-up position and get back into the rally. Incredible.
Yeah, that's it. So it's over, 12-8.
Well, you heard the Indian girl encouraging herself there, saying that's it. The rally working exactly how she wanted.
Just outside her reach this time.
So it's over, 9-12.
Well, Michelle Lee flicking the shuttle to the forehand. Sindhu attempted to stretch for it. You saw the footwork wasn't quite there. Four at the interval is now down to two, and Michelle Lee is working her way back into this second game. And again, the attack down the forehand side from Sindhu is proving to be successful. That is where she's getting most success. Full smash down the forehand side. Michelle Lee unable to get the racket back in time to bring the shuttle back over the net.
The variety on that around the head smash 11, this time, 15. The steep drop.
Yeah, we've seen the cross-court power. This time it's the cut straight. That shot is so difficult to retrieve. It comes down with pace. It's not power, but it's a little slice and it really brings the shuttle down quickly.
So the silver, 14.
Doesn't falter from her attacking strategy, though, does she?
No, I mean, that's her game. That's her game plan. And it works for her. She's nearly in the top 10 in the world, attacking badminton. It's going to win her a lot of matches moving forward. And it's got her the lead here in the second game. But a beautiful drop shot by Michelle Lee. The reverse slice, she really does have all the options overhead, whether it's the cut, the cross court, this time brushing around the shuttle. Again, it's not a slow drop shot, it actually comes down with a little bit of pace. Real quality there from the Canadian girl. She's finding her way back into this second game. Now just to within one. Again, the athleticism around the head. Sindhu trying the attack down the forehand side once again. Making the mistake on the attack, though.
Thank you.
that is high quality by Michelle Lee, attacking, moving forward, bringing the games back level. We do have Indians celebrating here in the arena, David.
We do indeed, because Palapari Kashyap has beaten Rajiv Youssef 18-21, 21-17, 21-18 to reverse the result of the semi-final 4 years ago in Delhi.
An absolute marathon men's singles, 83 minutes, incredible match. And coach Puella Gopichand takes his seat behind the ladies' singles court now after seeing his men's singles player be successful. He'll be hoping for the same from Sindhu.
So the server, 15-14.
See Puella Gopichand already giving instructions to his player as soon as he's taken his seat, really encouraging her. Saw him celebrating on the adjacent court just minutes ago, and he's straight back into the action, encouraging his player Sindhu.
Backhand
16
from Sindhu. She's putting the pressure on, maintaining that attacking style. This time it's the backhand push. Really good aggression, really going at the body, a great tactic in singles. If you're early on the shuttle, pushing it out of the body, so difficult for your opponent to get it back to the rear of the court.
Choice of shot from Michelle Lee straight at her opponent.
Yeah, the backhand. That shot right there. Nowhere near close enough to the line. She knew it. And in the end, it was an easy, easy put away for Sindhu. Not really even having to move wide for that one. It was 14 all. 3 points in a row. She's opened up the lead once more.
Oh, what a miss. The net court has given her a wonderful 15, opportunity.
17.
And it was one of those shots. The shuttle was just hanging there with no pace. It looked like an easy put away. That could be crucial in this second game. 18-14 would have been a healthy lead. Looking like taking it to a decider. Michelle Lee, with that miss, moves back to just within two behind.
Language has got to be good, he says.
Yeah, it's got to be strong, got to be positive.
She did lead by 2 points even deeper into the 15, first game, 18-16. So don't write this lady off just yet insofar as this game is concerned.
No, the Indian just seems to be the aggressor at the moment, really, really going for the win. Michelle Lee seems to be more reacting to the attack of Sindhu. Michelle Lee wants to take this in two games. She needs to be aggressive, and there
16,
it is.
17.
She's back for the overhead there, bringing it down. Back to that round the head weapon. It doesn't seem to matter how low the shuttle is round the head. She always gets round it, plays the forehand.
Please welcome all to the team event, and number 40 at Glasgow 2014, representing Malaysia, Team Jingyi.
It's just gone long.
So the silver.
Well, as the rally 18, went on, 16. You think Michelle Lee was starting to get control of the rally. Sindhu's attack negated as the rally goes longer and longer. Michelle Lee unable to keep the shuttle in the court. A great chance to draw level there. It's missed. And a 2-point gap. For Sindhu.
That's nice.
Beautiful play by Michelle Lee.
17-18.
A little punch over the head of Sindhu on the forehand, then steps in. And that is a really nice touch at the net. That one over the head, stepping in, pushing it across, just pushes the tape as it goes over. Second game just as tight as the first one.
Won by Michelle Lee, 22-20 on her second game point. And just as she did in the first game, she levels at 18-all.
Well, that's clever. The previous rally, she punched the forehand over the head. This time she stops it short of Sindhu. Real clever tactics by Michelle Lee. Got to remember what you did in the previous rallies, changing it all the time, keeping your opponent off guard.
And now it's 3 points in a row 18. For Michelle Lee.
And she's looking the more composed player on court at the moment. Controlling the shuttle, being patient, not going for too much too soon.
And it's the first time in the second game that the number one seed has been behind.
Fantastic effort by Michelle Lee.
19.
She was almost falling backwards there. I think she thought Sindhu would play it right to the rear of the court, but she almost gave her a chance with the push. She pushed it. She thought it was over. Had a little chance. When you're on your heels, I think she was more protecting herself from the kill and decided to go for it.
Gone long. And now it's game point for Sindhu. 19. She didn't have any in the first game.
So the silver. 20-all.
Well, the game point is saved by Michelle Lee. And again, like the first game, it goes to 20-all.
It's funny, they've played, this is the third game they've played in this tournament where it's gone to 20-all. And so far, Michelle Lee has won 2 out of 2.
Well, there's so little between these two ladies. which one of them is going to be brave here at 20 all. Michelle Lee trying to clinch a place in the final. Sindhu trying to save her tournament right now.
Would you believe it? She got it back. She hit the net and dribbled 20. Over. And it's match point Lee.
Huge celebration by the Canadian camp. Sindhu can do nothing about that. The net cord kills the shuttle. The Canadian coaches are excited. Their last athlete in. They got a chance to be involved in a gold medal match. For a place in the final, Michelle Lee has her first match point.
The number one seed in the men's singles lost in the quarterfinal, and now the number one seed in the women's singles goes out in the semi-final. She at least will have a chance to play for the bronze, but Canada are guaranteed a medal, and you know it could well be gold.
Well, we said this semi-final may well produce the gold medal winner, an absolute delight for Michelle Lee.
Match won by
and
Michelle
the Canadian
Lee.
Coaches. 22, there's the Canadian 20. Players. Lost earlier in the tournament, but they're all here to support Michelle Lee, and the Canadians have a chance of gold.
Well, she showed just how much he improved at the All England Championships earlier this year in Birmingham by reaching the quarterfinals, and this young woman is really emerging now as a very top-class singles player.
Well, she just showed her steel there at the end of both games. Such a tight match, 22-20, 22-20, and it was Michelle Lee who held her nerve. She had the look right at the end of the second game, the net cord on the defence, but she was aggressive on match point and it paid dividends.
And that's nice, even the Indian fans asking Michelle for an autograph, even though they will be desperately disappointed that PV Sindhu, the number one seed, has been unable to defend the women's singles title won for India by Saina Nehwal 4 years ago. 22-20, 22-20, a magnificent contest.